Hey, what's up, gurus? Welcome to Azure This Week. I'm Brian Rehm, and I'll be taking you through what's been happening in the world of Azure. Or not happening, because, well, it's kind of a desert out there right now. There is still good news for you, however, in that I've decided not to bore you to death with extremely minor updates, and instead, focus on certifications. So for this week, let's dive into what's new, what's changing, and how do you find all of this amazing information out. So what are you waiting for? Let's get started. And speaking of getting started, let's start with the foundation, or foundation level certifications. And at this level, there are no new certifications, so when you're looking at the foundation level, you should come up with three: Azure Fundamentals, Azure Data Fundamentals, and Azure AI Fundamentals, or AZ900, DP900, and AI900, respectively. Oh, and just a note, you'll find a link to all of the courses mentioned in the description below the video. The AZ900 was updated on May 5th, 2022. Luckily, it was only a minor change. The AI900 is very similar with a minor change at the end of April, and the DP900 will update on August 4th with minor changes as well. The key takeaway from this level is that there's nothing to worry about if you're in the process of studying. Hooray! Next up is our associate level certifications. Now there are a whole bunch of associate level certifications, 12 to be exact. Rather than go through all of them, I'm going to focus on the major updates. First up, and maybe one of the most popular certs, the AZ104 or Azure Administrator. This is getting an update on July 28th. It is unfortunately a major revision with major updates to almost every section, including the audience profile. So if you're in the process, either speed up and take it before the 28th, or make sure to add a few weeks and include the updates in your study routine. The DP300, or Administering Relational Databases, is next. This is an interesting one in that about 30% of the current exam is getting removed. This will obviously place a much greater focus on the remaining topics. This exam will be updated on August 4th, so not a lot of time here either if you're in the process of preparing. The AZ600, or Configuring and Operating a Hybrid Cloud with Microsoft Azure Stack Hub. Whew. Say that five times fast. Well, it's also getting a pretty major update on July 29th, so keep that in mind. That's it for the major updates, but almost every associate level exam will either have recently had or very soon will have updates, although mostly minor, coming your way. So keep watch out for that. Every month, a cloud guru has a number of totally free courses, which change over time. This month is Security Month, so perhaps you could try out the Introduction to Azure Security. We've also got a few other Azure courses available too, such as Intro to Serverless on Azure and Azure Storage Deep Dive. A free account is genuinely free as well. No credit card needed, just content delivered. Finally, we have two expert level certifications, the Solutions Architect and the DevOps Engineer. The Solutions Architect, or AZ305, had an update in the last couple of months, including changes to how the certification was earned. It now requires a prerequisite certification. The good news is that there are no pending updates. The DevOps Engineer certification also had similar changes. Unfortunately, the AZ400, or the main exam for this certification, just had major revisions to almost every section as well on July 13th. Hey, wait, that's this week. Oh. So if you're preparing for that certification, make sure you catch up on all the updates. So that brings me to how do you find out all this amazing or not so amazing information out? The best way to find out about updates is to go to the certification exam. Make sure it's the exam, though, and not the certification. Once you get there, scroll down and look for either a Download Exam Skills button or look for a tip box with a download study guide. It looks like Microsoft is in the process of changing the exam page, so all of them will eventually have the tip box and download study guide. Once you get there, scroll all the way down to the bottom for the updates. You can see that when you move all the way down, you will see a detailed skills measured section as well as a quick breakdown of the changes to each section. My strong advice to you is to review this as you start preparing for an exam, and then review it again just before scheduling. Hey, wait, doesn't a cloud guru take care of that? Well, of course we do. However, Microsoft doesn't tell us before pushing updates, so we have teams dedicated to reviewing these documents and figuring out the impacts on your exam and our training materials. As you can guess, something major like the AZ-400 will take some time as we have to review all the changes and create more amazing content to set things right. This process works great, unless you're planning on taking the exam next week, so do yourself a favor and be prepared. If you're looking to start a new certification and want to know the best path, make sure to take a look at the resources below, like our Azure Certification Guide, to learn more about the certifications available and which one is right for you. My suggestion will be to take a look at the resources, go online and search jobs to see which ones hold your interest, reach out to us on Discord, links below, and ask questions, and maybe go for an entry-level certification or two to test the waters and learn a little bit more. As you can see, even if there's not a lot going on in the news, there's still a lot going on in the world of Azure. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have for this Azure This Week. Sad to say goodbye, but I do have some good news. We'll be back next week with hopefully some new updates. It will definitely be a show you won't want to miss. Until then, keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.